When I start to lay hands on the sick, let me give you one more quick example. You have a, say a doc, now, okay, this may sound sexist. Leave me alone, I'm old. Okay? So, but I'm going to use specific genders. I'll only use two. Because that's all there is. Okay? There's him, her, and confused. Okay? Now, so you take a doctor. We'll say it's a he. Then we'll take a nurse. We'll say it's a she. Right? Just for the sake of illustration. Could be reversed. I don't have a problem with that. Just saying. But you have a doctor and a nurse. Now, if they have worked together very long, the nurse will know what the doctor's going to do. He'll tell her, we're going to go in, we're going to do this, we're going to do that. We got that kind of surgery. Yep, it's going to be done. Okay, nothing special. Yep, typical, we're going to do it. All right, that doctor nurse will go in there. They'll get the patient ready, and then the doctor will be doing his thing. And if they have worked together long, and if they work together good, they'll be in sync. And the doctor will not even, unless it's something special, will not even have to say what he needs. Why? Because the nurse isn't looking at the doctor. She's looking at what the doctor's doing. She knows where he's going to go next. She's got the tools laid out, the instruments, so that whenever he does this, all he has to do is put his hand out. She will put in his hand exactly what he needs for the next step. You got that? Now, that's what happens in the healing line. Now, I'm the doer. I do. The Holy Spirit is the one that makes it happen. He supplies the power. But what he does is this. He's a helper. If I don't lay hands, he can't help. But here's what he does. He doesn't just help. Every person is different in necessarily what they need. Now, they all need life, but there's specifics. So when I start, now listen, when I start to put my hand on a person, let's say I put it on their head, just before I touch them, the Holy Spirit, my helper, my nurse, knows what I'm going to do. He knows what they need. So before my hand touches them, he takes the tool that is right, slips it in my hand, so when I touch them, they get what they need. That's the way he works. He's a paraclete, one called alongside to take hold of together against. He's there to help me do. I got to do, but he slips in what I need. So if I need a word of knowledge, it'll be there. If I need a gift of healing, because there are gifts, plural, of healings, he can give me whatever gift I need at the time. Do you understand that? That's what he does. He is in us, and all the gifts are in him. So whatever the need is, he can put that in your hand at that moment, or put it in your mouth. He can put the word. Does this make sense? Are you getting a picture of the paraclete, the helper that's there to help you? Now, notice this. When I lay hands on a sick, I have no inherent power in me necessarily to heal the sick. But I have the joystick, which does what? Magnifies the power that is necessary to the point that it's necessary so that it accomplishes my employer's will. Does that make sense? Now, that's what he does for you, if you'll do it. He is your helper. He's not just my helper. He's your helper. And he will help you. Now, notice, it is strange that most of the time when he helps that way, a lot of times it's helping you help somebody else. And that's why we need the body, because sometimes you need help, and it needs to come through somebody else. Now, there's been times that I did this. Why? Because there was no one else around, and I laid hands on myself. Strangely enough, it worked. You think, well, isn't that kind of a closed circuit? Yep. But I decided now. And that's when it worked. Is this making sense to you? This is your helper. This was the reason for Pentecost. So that he could come in you, dwell in you, walk in you, talk in you. He can share, he can lead and guide you. And I'm telling you, listen, I haven't always emphasized this aspect. But it's always been there. But the church is growing now, growing up spiritually to a point where, okay, now it's time to start sharing this. Why? Because if we're not careful, people will get weird. Weirder. Okay? That's what'll happen. Why? Because they'll start thinking, oh, this is the Holy Ghost. That's the Holy Ghost. No. God made man a physical man in a physical world, put spirit in that man, and expects us to walk through this physical world. So we don't have to be weird. Amen? Now, there's times you can get overwhelmed and people might think you're drunk. Not a problem with that, but not while you're preaching, not while you're ministering to people. Why? That's not the time for you to be blessed. That's the time for them to be blessed. See, when that happens, that's you getting blessed. And if you're going to do that, just go ahead and fall down and get out of the way.